Opposition banners call for peace, no for civil war. But reality is, Yemen is at a stalemate, a nation teetering on the brink of chaos. New government demands President Saleh remain in power until a replacement is elected fly in the face of an already signed deal he stepped down. What happens next depends much on arguably the country's second most powerful man.
We're going into General Ali Mugsen's compound now. It's like an army base. In fact, it used to be an army base. Got the military vehicles up here, all the soldiers on duty are in uniform.
He switched from army to opposition 3 months ago.
General Ali Mugsen is still effectively the commander of the 1st Army Division. He took the whole division with him when he deserted the president.
Overnight, Mohsen brought muscle to the calls for peaceful reform. Now the opposition does nothing without his approval and is rejecting talks that keep the president in power.
This is a principle that we must follow because there are agreements that sides have signed, and it is compulsory that all sides agree on its specifics, not change its points.
Government loyalists say they won't shift their position either. They'll wait for the opposition to crack first, put the pressure on the opposition to feel that if they don't sign up, then they'll be the ones responsible for starting a civil war. In an interview with CNN, Yemen's vice president made news, saying he has the power. Our President Saleh is in Saudi Arabia, recovering from an assassination attempt, to cut a deal. General Mohsen doubts it.
The vice president has said that he has full power to negotiate and he can sign any document, that the president is out of the country, he's sick, he's incapacitated. So why can't you just do a deal with the vice president?
Our brother, the vice president, is wise and all respect him. But in truth, he does not act with full authority as president of the Republic of Yemen.
Both sides claim war can be avoided, but appear deadlocked. All because President Saleh refuses to budge.
The feeling of stalemate is heightened by government jets taking off to attack targets not far from the capital. Not exactly clear exactly what they're hitting. The capital itself surrounded and cut off from the rest of the country. Government checkpoints on all the roads in and out of the city.
They've tasted war here before. None have the appetite for a repeat. But none have the recipe for peace either. Nic Robertson, CNN, Sana'a, Yemen.